everyone, welcome back to the Science for Kids channel. Today, we'll be doing something called the floating egg experiment. So of course, we'll need an egg. And of course, floating, and what floats? What do we need to float it in? Water, duh. And of course, you may not have expected this, but we'll need salt. And you'll also need a spoon and a mixer. So the apparatus is a beaker with water inside, or you can just use a cup. But we're using a beaker because it's transparent and we want you to see. Let me tell you, brown eggs don't work as well as white eggs. But if you don't have any white eggs, just use a brown egg. It is pretty similar, but brown eggs are as good as white eggs. Basically, eggs don't float. Apparently, our eggs sink in water. But let me tell you how they float. And of course, we'll need a spoon to take the salt out. We'll first use our spoon and pour in some salt into the water. And you may be wondering, what the heck are you doing? Now, we mix it with this. Alright guys, so we finished mixing. We'll take this guy out and we'll put an egg in. Apparently, it floats. See if you can see this, but it floats. Wait, why is the egg even floating in the first place? It should have sank, right? That's what you did in the first thing. Then it quickly just sank to the bottom. Well, now I'll explain. Basically, this is something called density. Let's say we have a cube. It is 1 centimeter tall, 1 centimeter long, and 1 centimeter deep. Our cube has 4 metal balls inside. Let's say there are 4 metal balls inside the cube. And no, I'm not saying the balls are really tiny balls. It doesn't matter, it's just for perspective. And basically, we put in 4 metal balls. And there's a second cube, let's say. And the second cube, which has the same dimensions as the first cube. Of course, if you don't know what dimensions is, let us know in the comments, we'll answer it. And basically, the second cube, this cube, we turned it into water. And after this cube, we tried to float it in the water. But what happened? Well, basically, this cube would float because it is less dense. And by less dense, I mean less balls. So this cube has less balls than the other cube, which means this cube would float. So let's say this is water, right? And we have an egg. An egg is more dense than water. When we put it inside, it sank. But after we added the salt inside, the salt increased the density of the water because there was more cubes. Let's say the salt are balls, right? And we put them inside the water. So there will be more material inside the same amount of water. Then it became more dense. Then when we try to put the egg back inside, it floated. So yeah, that's how basically what it means, that's the science behind it. And again, thank you for laying us an egg. Half human, half chicken hybrid. Anyway, we'll see you next time. Goodbye.